Adam Savage here in my shop with a tool tip for you. And I'll be honest, I try and keep my tool tips to super affordable tools that everyone should have. I like doing that for the bulk of my tool tips, but this one involves a really esoteric tool that is kind of spendy, but there's not many other things that does exactly what it does as well as it does. And I wanted to introduce you to it because it's useful to know what is out there. So for today's tool tip, I've got a piece of, hold on, let's get some perspective on this. All right. So for today's tool tip, I have a piece chucked in on top of the vise of my milling machine. And I want to do some milling operations, but because this is just clamped onto the top of my vise, I need some indication of exactly where it is. And I could do a edge finder like this and this, but instead I'm going to do all my machining operations off of the concentricity of this hole. So what I need to be able to do is line up the quill of my mill with this hole exactly. And there is a tool that does that. There are lots of inexact ways you could do this, and I have done many of them over the years, and I'm here to tell you, wherever precision is concerned, inexactitude can lead to lots of long tail unintended consequences. Maggie hears somebody. Maggie, what are you complaining about? I'm just talking to the camera. Okay, so we're going to see what tool gets perfect concentricity between your quill and a hole on the mill. The tool we're going to use is colloquially known as a wiggler. I'm not sure of the exact official name of this tool, but it is a measuring instrument. Here's what it looks like. And it wiggles. So when it wiggles, it shows a certain amount of movement on the dial. And we're going to use that movement to precisely calibrate the concentricity of the quill of the mill to the hole. And first things first, you make your job a lot easier using a wiggler if you get close to start. So I've chucked in a end mill into one of my collets, and I'm just gonna roughly set it here. I'm gonna bring it down to the hole, and I'm going to just get within a few thou of center, right? Like by eye, I mean, this is the thing about close enough is that you can get within probably 10 or 15 thou, 10 or 15 thousandths. That's like five or six sheets of paper in terms of precision, but that, like, that way lies madness. You don't want to try that, but you can get close. You can get within 10 thou. So I'm pretty pleased with where that is. I'm going to pull it back out. And now it's time to activate the wiggler. So I'm gonna lower this down a little bit. Oh, hey, I forgot. I'm shooting videos. I should actually give you a close-up bit of B-roll. Centered. Here we go. Yeah, okay. I know on camera that doesn't look incredibly perfectly centered, but to be honest, it is pretty close. Yeah, that's not bad. Okay, I think that's within a few thou. Just mark my DRO so I'm close. Okay, great. So I will remove that collet and the end mill. We're going to break out a collet that fits the spindle of my wiggler. Thank you. By the way, thank you to everyone in the comments who was telling me the official name of this tool and what it is called. Jamie had one years ago that he picked up when the old Chris Whalis's shop shut down. And I think I had to ask Chris Rand what the hell this thing was called. He guided me towards where I could find one. But I don't quite remember. Okay, so the wiggler is in place. You know what? I'm gonna lower this. Let me get a close up on this. So here's how the wiggler works. When you're about to activate the wiggler, you need to choose a probe that is appropriate for the size of hole that you're going to. You can use really big probes like this for holes. I don't know what the maximum of this, but when I look at this, I'd say that could measure the inside of a hole that's at least 7 or 8 inches in diameter. This little hole I have here is about a half inch. So I'm just gonna chuck in this little bitty probe. There's a wrench here for that probe, but I don't really need it. And then this spins here. And so to prevent it from spinning, you have an extension arm here, and the extension arm bangs into this stop here. I've used this little magnetic stop on the clamping setup. Okay, so now the wiggler is ready to be used, and we are going to lower the speed of our mill to the low speed, and I'm gonna, let's see. Turn it on and lower the speed. All right. So, maybe you can already tell what's gonna happen here, but here's how it's gonna work. Every marking on this gauge is half of a 10,000th. Sorry, half of a 1,000th. Every marking on this gauge is 5/10 or 5/10,000 of an inch. Oh yeah, really, really precise. So what I'm gonna do is I'm going to bring this probe into contact with the interior of the hole. Now, when I turn the machine, you'll see that this dial starts moving like this. And what'll happen is I will use the XY handles on my milling table to dial in until the dial doesn't move. And when the dial doesn't move anymore, well, that means that we are concentric with the hole. So let's do it. Now, the philosophy of doing this is a process of moving each of the handles until you see more movement on either side and you start dialing to the middle. And then you move the other one and you move it until you see more movement and then less movement, more movement and less movement. And you keep on doing that, X and Y, X and Y, X and Y. Eventually, you bring it to where, as you saw, the dial wasn't moving very much at all. Now, I've got some noise in my system. My spindle probably needs to be rebuilt. The bearings need to be repacked. This mill was born in 1968, after all. I don't know when the last time the head was rebuilt, if ever. So that noise causes the needle to move around a little bit because it's a sensitive piece of equipment. However, I'm familiar with the operation of this one enough, and you can watch YouTube videos of other guys with better mills, and you can just see that dial eventually just stops moving. With the noise in my system, there's a bit of vibration, but yeah, the wiggler is how you get that level of precision. Now, you can also measure the outside of a hole. I could have centered on the outside of this. All the different probes that are part of the wiggler allow you the ability to basically center on any kind of circle, an interior or an exterior circle, from super tiny to a punch point, all the way to probably something about this big in diameter. These cost a few $100. They're not cheap, maybe a couple $100. However, I will say I use this thing almost weekly. And when you get pretty good at it, the setup is not as laborious as it may have seemed in this video. Yeah, that's a wiggler. And that's how you center your machine above a hole. Thanks for joining me for this tool tip. I'll see you guys next time.